Welcome to Go Get It. Today we are going to explore the term delegate in C sharp. Before we proceed further, make yourself comfortable with the methods and properties in C sharp. In this video, we will see the basics of delegates. In the later session, we will discuss about the usage of delegate by taking some real world problems, and we'll end with multicast delegates. .NET framework has broadly classified types into two categories, value type and reference type. Structures are value type while classes are reference type. On the similar lines, delegates are also reference type. So what are delegates? Delegates are the function pointers. In fact, they are the type safe function pointers. In some time, we'll see the meaning of type safe function pointers. There are basically two different types of delegates. One is simple delegate and other is multicast delegate. In the later session, we'll discuss about multicast delegates. Those who belong to C++ background are very well aware of the term function pointers. Function pointer is a pointer that has a reference to a function or a method in C#. Let me explain this by taking an example. Here we have created a console application. As I said earlier, delegate is a reference to a function or a method. Now let's create a function. We'll create a function, say hello world. We'll create it as a static method, so we don't need to create an instance of the class. So say hello method, or better, we'll call it as hello world or default, with no parameters. So what it will do, we'll define it as, it will display a message when it is called as, this is a method, or we'll say that this is my first delegate. So we have created a method whose return type is a void type and which accepts no parameters. Now, as I said, it is a type safe function pointer. We'll see in some time what is type safe. Now, to call this hello world, we'll create a delegate. Now, let's see the syntax or the signature of a delegate. The signature or the syntax of a delegate is more or less similar to a method declaration, with the difference being a word keyword of delegate. Let us see how to declare a delegate. We'll declare it as, say, delegate method. That's all. You can notice here that except the word delegate, it is more or less similar to a method declaration. When we put the keyword delegate, it is making it as a delegate. Now, as I said earlier, that delegate method is of a reference type, so we need to instantiate a reference type. So to instantiate a reference type, we will do it like this. We'll call the delegate method, name it as delegate method equals to new delegate method. So to the constructor of this delegate method delegate, you can notice here it is accepting a function whose return type should be a void and there are no parameters passed. So here we have already created a method called hello world, which matches the signature of the delegate. So we'll pass hello world here. That's all, we are done. If we execute this, you can see this message displayed on the console. I guess something wrong has gone. Let's see what is wrong. Okay, we have missed to call the delegate method. So let's call delegate method here, with no parameters. So here we have registered the hello world method to a delegate, and after that we are calling the delegate method. As soon as we call this delegate del method delegate, it will call this function. So let's see now. That's all, it is displaying the message, this is my first delegate. Here we have seen a method with return type 0 and 0 parameters passed. Let's see one more example where we will pass a parameter. We will pass a string parameter, str message. So we'll display this message here. And the message is str message. That's all. So here you can see that this hello world method has been modified with the parameters str message. Now you can notice that this method definition and the delegate which we have declared, it doesn't match with the definition of the method, because here it is accepting, or it is accepting a parameter called string. So we'll pass here a string parameter, say message. As we have registered the hello world method here and it is accepting a string parameter, we will pass a parameter called this is my delegate. That's all. We'll execute, and you can notice here message passed, this is my delegate has been displayed here. Now let's see one more example where it will return some value. Now let me explain the typesafe function pointer terminology here. What do you mean by typesafe here? Here typesafe means, if instead of void, if we make it as integer, what will happen? Let's return 1 here. Now you can notice here that it is passing a return value as integer. But here you can see it is showing compile time error, as integer, the delegate has a wrong return type. So this is called as typesafe of a delegate. So we will, instead of void, we will write it as integer. And as this method is returning something, we will capture this in a return, say return value. And we will display this as return value placeholder, and we'll pass the integer type here. So what we are doing here, we have return type int and we have matched the delegate whatever we have declared here with the method. So after execution, you can notice here that return value 1 is printed here. I hope this has clarifies the delegate. Now let's see for the web developers. In web development, we have created a web page here, say default.aspx, with a button and a label. Now what it does, to explain the delegates here, the web developer must be knowing about the button click event. So delegates are basically used for event handlers. So there are two different ways of declaring a button click event. One way is to declare the button click event in the default.aspx, or one way is the default.aspx.cs file. Let's declare it here. Okay, we'll stop it first. Now let's see how to declare delegates, or how to use the delegate in the form of event handler. We'll call this dot button 1 dot click. Click is nothing but the event associated with the button, plus equals to, don't bother about plus equals to, we'll see this in the very detail in multicast session. So we'll create here. You can see that event handler, which is accepting a button 1 underscore click named method. So here you can see that event handler is a delegate which is accepting a method called button 1 underscore click, which is declared here. This is nothing but a method which is for button click event, which accepts two parameters, object and event args. So behind the scenes, if you see, this event handler is nothing but a delegate. See, this is a delegate which accepts parameters, object and event arg, which is same as here. So we have registered the button one click method with the event handler delegate. So if we execute this, or if we compile this, you can see that we have registered the button click event to the button. This is the button. On click of this, it will display the message button is clicked. So we have seen that the syntax or the signature of a delegate. The delegate is a keyword with a result type. Result type is nothing but which matches the return type of the function. Identifier, the name of the delegate, and the parameters, which is optional. We have seen all the three cases: with parameter, without parameter, and with return type. Delegates are mainly used for calling multiple methods using multicast delegates. It is used in event handlers and simpler implementation of design patterns, etc. I hope you are clear with the basics of delegates. Thanks for listening. Keep watching. Have a good day.